spring anime season has been pretty banging. There's a lot of great stuff, but one show in particular has kind of stolen the attention of the masses. So much so that it's the fifth highest rated anime on MAL, and it hasn't even finished. I'm of course talking about Spy X Family. It's a hit. We all love it. Anya is great. You're anyone? But getting caught up in the cuteness of this, you might not have realized that this anime is actually heavily inspired by a real-life location and time period. That is what I want to talk about today, because you might not know this, but I actually got an A in geography and history during my high school exams, which I'm still very proud of. I actually think setting is quite important to the style of Spy X Family. In fact, that is often the case for most anime, but I rarely see people talking about the connection. Take this example of when Anya and Lloyd go out for a walk in episode 1. The vibe you get from the street signage, the clothing people are wearing, and all of those little details, it really transports you into this world. Spy X Family definitely isn't set in the present day. That is pretty obvious. But if we do some investigating, we can actually pinpoint a specific time period and location that the anime is intentionally reminiscent of. Yes, Spy X Family is fictional and there's no actual place that is an exact carbon copy of the series. However, it is clearly a European-inspired country. This can be seen in things like the architecture and even the names of characters. But just saying it's set in Europe is not precise at all. While it is true that Spy X Family is drawing from multiple countries for its overall vibe, when you look deeper into it, there's certainly a primary inspiration. So, as you'll know if you've seen Spy X Family, the setting is largely two post-war nations that are distinctly divided, Westarlis and Ostana. Lloyd Forger is an agent working for WISE, which is an organization from the Westarlis side. Their goal is to uphold the peace of the two nations, as Ostana did attack Westarlis in the past. So the backbone of the series follows Lloyd operating in Ostana, carrying out missions with this objective in mind. If you weren't asleep in history class, you'll know that a certain country at a certain time was also divided in a similar fashion. Germany.
Berlin's Communist Congress transforms itself into a parliament and chooses Burly Wilhelm Peck, Germany's communist number one, as president of the new East German state.
In 1949, Germany was actually split into two independent nations following the Second World War, the Federal Republic of Germany and the German Democratic Republic. Now, going back to Spy X Family, we can see from this panel in the manga that the geographic border of Westarlis and Ostana looks very similar to that of West and East Germany. In addition to being physically similar, the two fictional nations in Spy X Family are heavily intertwined despite their quarrels. Characters from both states live across their respective borders, and of course, spying was a big thing back then. Actually, there's a Wikipedia page dedicated to listing individuals that spied against their opposing sides. There are definitely some more blatant parallels too, probably the most in your face being the naming of the two nations in Spy X Family. Westarlis, yes, that one quite literally sounds itself out, but also Ostana. If you take the first part of it, Ost, this actually means east in German. And of course, the crowning jewel, the capital of Ostana, is Berlin, which if you drop the T is the real world capital of Germany, still to this day. It's also where the Berlin Wall was built, a barrier which divided physically, but also represented the differing ideologies at the time. It was a symbol of East Germany's authoritarian control of its people, which is something that is heavily present in what we see of Ostana in Spy X Family. So that pretty much confirms that the author of Spy X Family wanted to capture the atmosphere of a divided Germany in the setting of their work. But if you really look at it under a magnifying glass, the attention to detail to the time period and place is truly interesting. Socially and politically, Ostana and Westarlis are aligned in ways that are representative of East and West Germany. Here's a more obscure example for you. In communist East Germany, education was of significant importance. It was a high priority for the government, being compulsory till age 16. Sure, it wasn't as insane as Eden Academy, which actually would never have existed in East Germany due to it being a private school, but the whole value of schooling in general in Ostana is quite similar. All of this makes for a side of the series that makes me even more engaged with it. It's like hunting for Easter eggs in a video game. I love the little things particularly, like references to the region at large. Even Hungaria, Hungary, makes an appearance. Sure, none of that makes Spy X Family any better or worse, but I still think it's interesting to know about, and it does raise an important question. East Germany and West Germany were eventually unified, and perhaps that will be how Spy X Family ends, with the Forgers able to live happily. Lives. Who knows? What I do know is that Spy X Family is pretty great, and so are you, for sticking to the end of this video. I've been Russ, and have a great night, or day.